Hello, I'm Gabrielle. I did an MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence at Cambridge this year. Today, I'm going to share with you my tips on how to apply for a master's degree at Cambridge, how to choose the right program for you, the interview process, personal statement, choosing courses and college, and much more. These are all things that I wish I knew before I applied, and so I hope this video would help prospective students. This is a highly requested video since I received a lot of questions through LinkedIn DMs asking me about my experience at Cambridge, how to apply to the course that I did. So I hope that this video would help you. The MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence at Cambridge is within the engineering department. It has overlaps with CS and stats. So it might be surprising if I tell you that I don't have a background in engineering. In fact, I did my bachelor's degree in economics. I did a BA in economics at University of Chicago. After I graduated, I worked in management consulting focused in the finance industry. Then I did this MPhil at Cambridge. Now that I've finished, I'm currently working full-time as a software engineer. I have a few tips for you on how to choose a university and how to choose a master's program. Why Cambridge? There are three key considerations. Number one, the course. Number two, the network. And number three, the funding. Number one, the course. I knew that I wanted to do a master's in engineering or CS, and Cambridge has an excellent engineering program. In particular, the MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence really attracted me because it has a wide range of topics in machine learning, ranging from computer vision to natural language processing. Also, it has a great faculty, and I think I could learn a lot from them. The faculty are experts in the field and also leaders in the industry. Number two, the network. Cambridge has a huge global network of alumni and students that you could leverage. You could meet lots of interesting people during your time here and also form connections with people in your field so that you can learn more from their experience and possibly find a career that you really want. Number three, funding. I find that compared to some other universities, Cambridge offers more merit-based scholarships that are open to people from different backgrounds or different nationalities. Not only does the university offer scholarships, but the department and some colleges offer scholarships to people who fulfill some criteria. Furthermore, there are even outside corporations that offer scholarships, some of which are full-ride scholarships, meaning that it not only covers the tuition costs, but also college fees and living costs. This makes it a more attractive option to apply to because there are more funding options. I have two tips for you on how to choose a master's program. Number one, consider your career goals and which program fits it the most. Number two, what are the entry requirements of the program and which ones you fit? So number one, your career goals. For me, I know that I wanted to be a software engineer specialized in machine learning. And so I only applied to one program at Cambridge, that is the MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence. I also recommend prospective students to only apply to one master's program at Cambridge because number one, applying to multiple programs incur more application fee. And number two, there are probably differences between the courses that you apply to. And by figuring out what are the differences and figuring out which one best fits your career goals, then you could make a decision earlier on and start preparing for that course from the moment you submit your application. It is much better than making the decision once you've received all those offers, because at that time, you would already be at a stage where you're prepared to start your program. How do we figure out which program suits our career goals the most? We can look at the course website for what classes the program offers and what sort of research you could do in the program, and look at who are the faculties teaching this program and the faculty that you could ask to be your supervisor for your thesis. Also, if your goal is to do a PhD after the master's degree, then I recommend doing an MPhil with a heavy research component so that you can get used to doing research and have some experience in doing lab or whatever that is needed in your field. If your goal is to get a dream job after graduation, then look at which programs offer you the skill set that you need to do well in your dream job. Number two, entry requirements. Entry requirements are really important because applications are screened by these entry requirements, which are like the basic requirements needed to be considered further, and then your application will be evaluated further by other criteria. So please make sure to check out what are the entry requirements on the university and course websites.
If you don't fulfill them yet, make sure to try to fulfill them before you apply.
Entry requirements are the basic criteria used for screening applicants. Entry requirements could be broken down into two parts. Number one, degree qualification, and number two, academic background. Degree qualification means your results of the bachelor's degree. For the MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence, it requires a UK first class honors degree or an international equivalent. You could use this tool to check what is the international equivalent for your country. For me, since I did my bachelor's degree in the US, the equivalent for a first class honors degree is a 3.7 out of 4.0 GPA. Number two, for the academic background. It is a bit more ambiguous, but usually it is specified in the course website. For the MPhil Machine Learning Machine Intelligence, it requires a university-level math background. If applicants don't have the math background, they are recommended to apply to a different program called Advanced Computer Science. A suitable undergraduate degree includes engineering or a related technical field like math, CS, physics. It also says that an economics degree that is math-focused is sometimes suitable preparation for the MPhil. For me, I did the economics degree at UChicago, and I believe it is considered math focused because we covered calculus, linear algebra, econometrics, stats, etc. It also lists out a few bullet points of the math topics that applicants are supposed to know already. They include linear algebra, calculus, probability, inference. The econ degree at UChicago covered most of these topics, but it is a challenge to try to recall it because I'm considered a mature student, meaning that I did not go straight from undergrad to MPhil, and I worked for more than a year in industry in consulting, which doesn't require this kind of math background, so it's getting a bit rusty, so it might take a bit more time for me to pick it back up, but the good thing is I kind of had a little bit of background in it during my bachelor's degree. Now that we've narrowed down to which programs to apply to, how much time should we allocate to making an application? It depends on how competitive that course is. The more competitive it is, the more time we should spend on it to make sure we put our best foot forward. For example, the MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence shows the number of applicants and the number of offers made in the FAQ. It works out to be a 3.6% acceptance rate. So how low is this acceptance rate? Let's find a benchmark. Let's use the benchmark from Harvard and Stanford undergraduate acceptance rate. It is usually around 4%. So this 3.6% looks really, really low to me. Now let's look at another website to see if there's more information on the acceptance rate. This website shows that this MPhil is in fact the most competitive postgraduate course at Cambridge, and it received this number of applications. Note that there's a slight difference in the figures because the figure is from a different year, and I'm not sure how accurate it is since it is not given by Cambridge. Since it is a very competitive program, I highly recommend applicants to spend as much time as you could afford on the application, make sure there aren't any mistakes, and make sure that your essay is polished, etc. I have a three-step approach to help you write a good personal statement. Number one, figure out what are the key messages by drawing three circles. The first circle is what knowledge and experience you already have and you could leverage. The second circle is what are your career goals and things that you want to contribute to society after the master's program. There might already be some overlap between these two circles, which is good, meaning that you already have preparation for your career goals. And the third circle is the master's program. It ideally should fit somewhere in between these two circles you already drawn. And it shows like how this master program could bridge you from your current state to your future state and how it could help you achieve these goals. What are some things that you could do now to help you achieve those goals? Step number two is to chain together your key messages in the form of a story in a concise and direct manner. Why I wanted to emphasize being direct and concise is because it requires a different strategy from writing your Common App essay when you apply for a bachelor's degree in the US. For the Common App essay in the US, what they want to know is who you are and what's unique about you. So people could get away with using flowery language and metaphors that are really hard to understand from an objective point of view, but very stylistically interesting to read. However, it requires a different strategy when we apply for a master's degree in the UK, because we want to deliver the message that we are a suitable candidate, we have sufficient academic preparation for the master's degree, and that we could make a difference after doing this master's degree and contribute to society. So we want to focus on this message and not to distract our readers by using some flowery language or metaphors. Number three, proofread your essay strategically. I have two tips for you. Number one, you can use this tool called Grammarly, which is a Chrome extension and desktop app. It could help you proofread and check for grammatical mistakes. Another tip for you is to ask a friend or someone you trust to proofread your essay and give you feedback. Preferably, it would be someone who has gone through the master's application process, whether it's in another country or for Cambridge, because they could give you really valuable feedback and help you avoid any common pitfalls. Apologies that it's getting dark here. I should end my video soon. I'm really sorry that it's so dark now because I've been filming for over 6 hours and the sun has set and I don't have any good lighting around me.
Excuse me?
So I'm currently just using my bike lights as a temporary source of lighting. Hope you don't mind the weird lighting and hopefully I could end this video soon and continue in my next video. The application process varies from program to program and from year to year, so please make sure to check the university website for the most updated information. I'll give an overview for the MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence. Applications open on September 1st, and applications are due on December 2nd. The interview dates depends on different factors. For me, I had my interview in January, and then I received my offer from the MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence in February, around a month later. Then I received my offer from my first choice college, Magdalen College, around 1 month afterwards. I submitted my application in September, so it was pretty early. And I highly recommend prospective students to apply early as well, in case applications are reviewed on a rolling basis. Also, applying early has the benefit of getting interviews early. I noticed that some of my peers had their interviews a few months later than mine, and I think one of the reasons is that I applied super early, so maybe the interview schedule is also dependent on when you applied. A lot of people ask me what's the MPhil in Machine Learning and Machine Intelligence interview like. I have to start by saying that the interview format and content varies from person to person. It's different for me and my peers and people who are a year younger than me. But let me share my experience. The interview format is a 20-minute Zoom meeting with two professors from the course. I received an invite in January, through email from the professor directly. Make sure that you reply to the professor promptly. I received my invite around 3 to 4 days before the actual interview date, so make sure that you check your email regularly. The task I was given is to prepare a presentation, a specific number of slides, and to present two things. Number one is to summarize a machine learning paper that I provided, and number two is to present my project on a machine learning related topic. Some tips for you on how to prepare for these two tasks. To summarize a machine learning paper, the first thing is to really understand the concepts and the key ideas of the paper. Although it's quite convoluted and really hard to understand a paper, what I suggest you to do is to read the paper over and over again and to write down and work out the mathematical equations to make sure that you understand the math and the idea behind the concepts they propose. Second, make the PowerPoint really nice and beautiful. I have a consulting background, and so I had some experience making PowerPoint and slides. Third tip is to do some machine learning related project while you have time, because quite likely is they would ask you to present a project that you did that's related to machine learning. And the benefit of doing a machine learning project on your own is to show that you have an interest in learning about machine learning on your own, which is a really valuable trait because the master's is a really independent program and we learn a lot of things ourselves. So it shows you can take the initiative to learn, and also it shows that you already know some of the things that will be taught in the course, which is great. In the second part of this video, I'm going to cover the thesis, the courses I took, how to choose a college, and other tips for prospective students. Please give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful, and please feel free to leave a comment down below letting me know if you like this kind of content or if you have a question that you would like me to cover in the next video. I'll see you in the next video very soon. Bye!